any manuscript, any research will contain a title page, اللي فيها title, and then the authors and their affiliations, يعني what university, what blah blah blah, okay? And then you will have the corresponding authors, so they will communicate with you. لما يقول لك hey, you got an accepted manuscript, ولا يقول لك you revised, ولا sorry, you've been rejected. وهذه حصلت لسه الأسبوع اللي فات. Fine, you can get rejected, ما عندك مشكلة, but keep trying. Now, and then you will have the abstract. Abstract is a summary in about not more than 300 words. Abstract contains introduction, methods, results, conclusion. كأنها mini, of course, it's a mini paper. And then your paper will really, should include introduction, rationale, methodology, or material. طبعا هنا الأسماء تختلف حسب البيبر, حسب الجورنال you are applying to. Then results, discussion, conclusions, you should include references, and you should also, if you have tables and diagrams, and sometimes you should have disclosure, يعني disclose no, there is no financial gain, there is nothing, this is approved by the IRB, by the Institute, يعني review committee, blah, blah, blah. Okay, for the manuscript, for the paper itself, it's around 3,500 to 4,500 words. It can be size 12, the font, and double space between the for the paragraphs. حتطلع معاك يمكن 12 to 15 pages. حتكون كنز كده تشوفها حاجة حلوة كده. You know what? I just keep flipping. It looks nice. This is my work. So now let me do the introduction. Introduction is the beginning of your high value work. دائما خليك you should be proud of your work. بس إذا أنت if you follow the steps that you do your best to really be scientific and objective. So this is the invitation to the reader. أنا as a, an independent reviewer, I receive your manuscript to review, to accept, to reject, or to modify. This is your invitation to me. No, you know what? Let me take you through this 4,500 words journey to really see my work. This is the introduction. It is the invitation. You should show your ideas. You should show the your intention to the reader. This will pull me all the way. لما أقرأ introduction شدني حكمل على methods, results, conclusion, blah, discussion, and conclusion. Now you should you start with the knowledge with the facts. مشكلة. This is introduction كأنها يعني you start with some facts, but you don't go too lengthy, and you only are limited of maybe one page, maybe a page and a half. Yeah, usually 10% in of your whole paper is at the introduction. That can be concise, and you need to really, you need to show me a very important fact. And you show me there is a gap in knowledge that you are trying to do your best to fill in that gap through your project. And there is knowledge. Still, we don't do everything. We didn't know everything. We're trying to answer this missing gap through our study. So you need to show me why your study is important. Again, to fill the gap in the knowledge in this particular issue. As an example, diabetes is associated with polyneuropathy, but we don't know how severe it will be if presented in young patients with diabetes. So, يعني فهنا كيف حبدأنا؟ ما حقعد عمل كل الانترودكشن about diabetes in details, complication, diabetes is known to, no. Because you don't want to waste your introduction in general. لا. Brief intro about the epidemiology of diabetes. على طول, boom, go to talk about complication of diabetes. اللي هي إذا كان polyneuropathy or the spectrum of polyneuropathy. اللي هو microvascular complications as an example. And then you drive me all the way to polyneuropathy. بعدين pull me toward the young who had neuropathy. And then that something we don't know for which, يعني حتى تقول انه there is a gap in this part of knowledge in a very common disease, بس انا اخذت لك very specific aspect, and now we try to answer to fill in the gap of this knowledge in diabetes, severity of neuropathy, or severity of diabetes in young with neuropathy as an example. طيب. So يعني, another يعني rephrase of the statement is detecting polyneuropathy in young patients may help to reduce complications related to polyneuropathy. Right? Or detecting polyneuropathy in younger population may detect other microvascular complications such as retinopathy or nephropathy. يعني this is the gap that you need to fill. So again, there is missing part of knowledge, and you try to fill this knowledge And that's the reason you want to do this study. فكر فيها بالثيمز هذا وترى you can really think. يعني حلاوتك الرايتنج حق البيبر وحين صعوبتها انك ابدا بهيدنجز and then يعني as a, your thought your organized thought in points and then fill. So when you want to do the introduction you should show me you know about the topic there is a missing piece of knowledge you're trying to fill and that's why you want to do this study so at least your study is interesting your study is important But again, background of the topic, brief literature review of the topic, brief, showed our tool, boom, to the point, who missing of knowledge, discussion about, you can discuss similar studies in the past, but that still did not really fulfill, and did not really cover this gap in knowledge. That's why you are doing the study. And then what is this gap? What is your aim? And then you can state your research hypothesis clearly in your introduction. Okay? So again, background information, what is the unknown, and how to fill this unknown. خلينا أدي example, not because I'm a neurologist, but at least it's an example of something common, the severity of polyneuropathy in young diabetics. هذا هو الفكرة اللي ببالك. كيف عملت لها formula حق research question, whatever, this is at least what is in your head. So you give me a brief introduction about diabetes, epidemiology, brief words about complications, على طول to the point. Don't say diabetes is defined as hypoglycemia, fasting blood sugar, blah, blah, blah. No, يعني, this is not the missing piece of knowledge that we know. We need to learn, to the point. And then you can really hit the relevant background information. Polyneuropathy in diabetics in general, I mean, how problematic, how disabling. So this is an interesting, important problem. And if there are any predictors, severity, prognosis, يعني, انت pull me to diabetes, at all, maybe microvascular complication or polyneuropathy, and then boom, pull me toward polyneuropathy in young. فإحنا يعني تخيل بدأنا general, that's to the point, concise, brief, I want to hit my target, اللي هو neuropathy in young, or the severity of diabetes in neuropathy in young, whatever the idea in your head. So introduction, again, should talk in depth about diabetic complications in young. يعني this is the other way, لأنه this is your target, complication, young, one aspect of complication, فتبدأ as part of your brief, other complications in young. So your work should be, يعني your statement should be strong. As an example, الآن, diabetes was reported in up to 26% of young Saudis, younger than 15 years. And you have to put the reference, the site. You have to put the reference. The macrovascular complications were twice as high as those with early type 2 diabetes compared to usual onset type 2. يعني أو مايكرو أو مايكرو حسب يعني مثلا خلينا نقول هنا مايكرو أحسن. So هنا قاعد أربط to the point على طول. You always يعني you need to cite whatever fact اللي تحطها. You can يعني throw some words from your own title. ارمي كلام هنا keywords عشان حس إنه you know what you are really going with the theme. The theme is diabetic complication with polyneuropathy in young population. فالtext حقك ما يكون حاجة بعيدة. No. يعني تفصلي في النيوروباثي والريتينوباثي وتلاقيك ما حطيت كلام في النيوروباثي. So you really put keywords from your title into your introduction into pulling me toward reading your introduction. When discussing the gaps in knowledge, you should show some literature review and what was done, what is still missing, and you express your opinion in a very strong language sometimes. In order to really that we need further understanding of the problem, which is fair. Finally, how would you proceed to really fill in this gap? يعني now you should state your research question. واضح أنها I'm sorry, your research hypothesis. There sometimes indirectly, ممكن you can throw a question in order to تقول what is the complication? What are the predictor of polyneuropathy in patient for the severity of diabetes, as an example. الآن أو تحط على طول statement as a hypothesis. And you should state your aim objectives and you can tell the reader what are you going to learn from this study. مزبوط. Very important observation, you know, you need to avoid passive voice. You need to use more of an active voice. يعني مثلا تكتب research has found painful neuropathy to increase by whatever in young. بدل ما تقول painful neuropathy was found to be increased blah blah blah. دائما خلي الكلام انه active voice. Always brief, concise, strong verbs sometimes will do the job. Don't use a lot of I, we. خليها انه the idea to do this, to tackle this, I will do this, we will do this. حتكون شكلها ألطف شوية. Start broad and boom, narrow till you hit the target. طيب, so methods, again, I'm sorry, introduction, just to make it brief. أبدأ ببريف background, لكن to the point, toward the complication of interest. أعمل review سريع على literature related to my topic. And then I express clearly that there is still missing piece of knowledge that we need to learn. And then I put my hypothesis and I put why this is important study. And then for يعني this is our aim, this is objective. It's my one page, صفحة ونص بالكثير. To the point, concise. وارمي دائما كلام من التايتل حقك, ارميه في الانترودكشن. Keyword توريني انه مهم ترى throughout the paper. نفس الثيم واضح, you are focused وانت فكرتك واضحة. ما يكون you are jumping from one idea to another as if you don't really have a clear objective, a clear target to show. لا, دائما خليها ثيم يمشي مع بعض. Now, when you write the methods, So for introduction was invitation. You welcome me to read. Methods, this is me start to trust you. As a reviewer, start to trust you and you are really doing a job. ببساطة, if someone want to replicate the work using exactly your method, you will have the same results, similar more or less. فهنا, this is your way to show this is how did we do it. طبعا دائما methods هنا في البيبر حتكون في الـ past simple, بينما في الـ proposal حتكون يعني we will collect data, we will examine patients, بينما هنا we collected data of 1000 subject diagnosed, blah blah blah. هذا الفرق. فهنا الـ manuscript كله في الـ past. So now you show me what did you do, how did you do the study, detailed and specific. لازم تكون specific. I know I will show examples of how specific sometimes you should be. And it is a step by step details of how did you select your patients, inclusion, exclusion, start to collect data. How did you interview them? How did you deal with data that are missing? And how did you think of validity and reliability for which you use this valid and reliable study design? How did you consider the confounding for which you will consider doing? I'm going to go, I will do subgroup analysis for sex, for example, because previous study showed maybe there is a sex difference that may be considered as a confounder. هذه كل أشياء تحطها إنه this guy is thinking and he's really writing in a very systematic scientific way. So again, people can read you what you did and they can replicate it. And it's important to write where the study was done. So this is a cross-sectional study conducted in King Faisal Specialist Hospital Research Center in Jeddah between January 2020 to June 2020, for example. So when, where, طيب, and we enrolled patients who were diagnosed to have diabetes for more than 5 years, isn't quite specific. I don't want a new diagnosis, but I want old diagnosis. So we enrolled patients who had diabetes for more than 5 years, who are younger than 40 years of age. هنا ما هو selection bias. هنا you are defining a population and who are also diagnosed to have polyneuropathy based on a nerve conduction study performed within the last 6 months. Accurate, very specific. We excluded patients who had polyneuropathy because of different reasons, and we excluded patients who had atypical type of neuropathy, and because neuropathy was found to be 40% in younger diabetics, while we estimated the sample size to be 400 subjects. كأنه أنا أقول إنه this is the way we come up with the sample size. طبعاً whatever method اللي عملته عمل عليه citation. أو ممكن تقول the methodology we used to enroll patients has been used previous study. ممكن تعمل زي كده, يعني أنا previous study عمل method, ولا ممكن تقول يعني أنت you did another study ونفس الميثودولوجي بس الآن different objective, different target. But you can write the study protocol was discussed previously, تحط citation. Has been used previously, عادي ترى, عادي, لأنه أهم شيء واضح. And how did you estimate the sample? يعني هذه قلناها. And then inclusion exclusion, تكلمنا عنها برضو. And then again, clearly state this is a cross-sectional study. خلاص or whatever other study design, and then how you should show how you going to measure your outcome. مثلا how do you collect the data, we enrolled everyone seen in neurology clinic with this exclusion, and then we interviewed patient by during the clinic visit, we give them this screening tool for مثلا whatever يعني neuropathy ولا painful neuropathy, what يعني high objective, I give it to everyone, I screened everyone, and at least this tool is reliable, valid, and you are going to really have a good quality findings. And then to minimize bias, patients were assessed in the same clinic during their routine follow-ups. يعني ما تقول مثلا I bring them مثلا in extra clinics, so it put more stress patient قال قالوا oh why they are calling me to a special clinic, or you can just patient was seen during the research clinic اللي هي one standard the same assessment, فواضح انه you minimize the bias with the during the interview. Again, standardized screening tools are the way to recover, to survive. يعني مثلا we use the fasting blood sugar of more than 126 milligram per deciliter to determine diabetics who are to be enrolled in the study. حط citation حق why this number is as an example. We also used hemoglobin A1C up to 6.4 to determine pre-diabetes. فهنا بدل ما أقول hemoglobin A1C was used to determine pre-diabetes, I أقول we used a value of 6.4 as an active voice to determine pre-diabetes. Again, screening tool, make sure they are valid, specific, reliable. حط citation مثلا we used John Hopkins screening tool for diabetes, وحط حقها for polyneuropathy, حط حقها reference. If you are changing the scale, sorry, this is typo. If you are changing the scale, مثلا you used في screening tools انت عدلت عليها, you should tell me why you change the scale. Is it because it has been used in practice in the hospital for 5 years and we found it to be valid and reliable, we published the new scale, تحطها. Or you have to really come up with a good reason why you changed the scale. لأنه people doesn't want, يعني as a reviewer, ما أبغى طالع في حاجة, why you make up the new scale? I don't know how reliable, how good, and I don't know if you are really measuring what you're supposed to measure. مزبوط؟ يعني, again, when you talk about scale, screening, diagnostic, blah, 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 always, هنا, ارمي كلام الريلابيليتي فاليديتي تو ريلي شو ان ذيس از ان يور هيد. فانا اقرا كلام يقول يو نو وات ديد ذير ايفورت تو ريلي كم اب وذ ا فيري ريلايبل اند فاليد ميثود. اجين وات ايفر ميثود يو يوز بوت ذا سيتيشن بوت ذا ريفرنس. سو انا اي هاف تو بليف يو ببساطه. ذا ريدر يو هاف دي هاف تو بليف ان ذيس از دان بروبرلي انستيد اوف او يو نو اي هاف ا لوت اوف بروبلم وذ ذا ميثود دي يوز اي كانت ريلاي اون ذا ريزلتس سو ذيس از اوت. هذا فرق كبير. طيب ميك شور اني ميجر you do is with explain. يعني هنا I want to measure مثلا neuropathy severity, I want to measure proteinuria, I want to measure painful neuropathy scale using this. For you have to really be always clear. Again, active voice instead of passive voice. And we use anxiety scale to screen for anxiety instead of anxiety scale was used for screening. Now, when you during the methodology, you should also put a section about data analysis. يعني we will use, ولا لا, we used هذه في past, هذه مو proposal. We used SPSS version 20 حق بين brackets IBM corporate, يعني citation حق هذه حق software نفسه. Or we use R, or we use Jump, or we use whatever statistical software with the version. كل حاجة واضحة. Sometimes حتى لو أنا مثلا استخدمت extensions to the software أضيفها. We cite them, put the references. We express a descriptive analysis, يعني type of studies you are going to do. أبغى أعمل descriptive analysis. I want to talk about mean, proportion, percentage. We also do bivariate analysis to look for this association between exposure and the outcome. ممكن تسميها باسمها. We use chi-square test. We use student T test. Whatever study, يعني ANOVA, whatever statistics to look for this. يعني تقول لهم إيش حنسوي. هذه مرة مهمة. And then to association, to really do the multivariable analysis. And I got to learn complicated studies. We did this regression analysis where we use neuropathy severity as outcome, and we use the duration of diabetes as the exposure that was adjusted for and considering age, sex, use of diabetic, anti-diabetic medications, blah, blah, blah. هذه كلها تحطها، هذه كلها تحطها. هذه يبغى لها وقت انت تعرف ايش الاستدي اللي عملتها عشان لما اقرا ريزلت اعرف انه this is what you did. طيب؟ انت ممكن حتى الميثودولوجي تحطها في سب هيدنجز، مثلا تكتب مثلا الهيدنج الاول انرولمنت، كيف عملت انرولمنت؟ داتا كولكشن، ايش الميثود اللي عملته؟ سكرينينج تول، ايش اللي عملته؟ بعدين داتا اناليسيس. فممكن تعملها هيدنجز كده عشان تكون واضحه اسهل فور ذا ريدر. مظبوط؟ You should always be transparent, specific in your details, and again show one method that you stated to do that should really express how transparent you are. And again, it is a matter of to show everyone that if you repeat the study, you will come up with more or less the same results. I think I'm almost done. طيب. Introduction versus methodology. So now in the intro again, you should be brief, concise, not more than 10% of your manuscript. Methods should be detailed, specific, well explained. ممكن مثلا تاخذ منك صفحتين صفحتين شوي ثلاث صفحات عادي. بس at least انه you clearly طبعا always in writing always you should also be concise. يعني you cannot instead of blah 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 ما لها داعي. لا you should always be concise لكن you put more details في methods more than the introduction. By the end of the introduction and methodology you should be about 40% of your manuscript ready, which is a really good achievement. I read your introduction, I read your methods, I can tell where what I'm expecting. فأقرأ الأسئلة الآن كلها smooth right. ترى وحشة لما الريدر الريفيور يقرأ المانوسكريبت حقك ويلاقي إنه يعني you are really jumping, you don't really have one theme, one flow, the ideas, كلها ترى ideas. هتيجي مع الوقت كلنا نتعلم. إلى الآن I make mistakes, you will make mistakes فعادي. بس هذه تبان إنه في theme واحد يمشي عليه. And then you will make my life easy to read your results, to read your discussion. لأنه أنا فاهم إيش قاعد تقول أنت. And then finally the conclusion. Successful manuscript as publication and acceptance will really depend big time على الانترو والميثود. لأنه ترى results تعتمد على اللي أنت عملته. الdiscussion يعتمد على الأفكار اللي أنت طلعت فيها على الريزلت حقتك. ف this should be taken very seriously. Again, hierarchy of evidence. I expect smart, mashallah عليكم, mid students to really come up with good case control, you will come up with good case cross-sectional studies, you will do it. حتى cohort, حتى experimental اللي هو randomized control, مو شرط انه medication, بس you can come up with experimental studies that it can really help. طيب آخر كلمة على qualitative research. هذا الشيء اللي احنا ما نعرفه كثير. ممكن نسويه ما احنا عارفين انه qualitative study. ممكن نيتي انه this is qualitative study بس boom I go to a different method. تلاقي I'm not really measuring what I'm supposed to measure because I'm just mixing and matching. Qualitative study ببساطة لأن الناس يعني أنتوا ذكياء وأنت you will understand what I'm talking about. حيعرفوا إيش قصدي بqualitative study. Qualitative study إنه مثلاً أي اللي أنا I have a problem I cannot measure. يعني I cannot measure how people suffer when they go to the emergency and you get frustrated and they really get annoyed by long wait, sometimes they have to leave the hospital to go to somewhere else because they're not satisfied. طيب فأنا كفكرة I sit with them. يأمنوا two options. أقول تعال كلمني إيش حاصل معك في الإمرجنسي. هو كل ما يتكلم أنا طفشان ويقولهم لقيت إنه waiting long waiting long. بعدين أقول إنه مثلا I found people rude. طيب. لكن whatever I can market أو إنه I sit with someone else. They may repeat the same. They may go to different opinion, or in a group. معهم بي أنا أريد أعمل my questionnaire. أقول له تعال خذ أمسكه. ممكن جاوب أنت قاعد هنا. أو أنا أسألك أنت جاوب أو أسمع أقول له أنت جيت الطوارئ قبل يومين أو قبل يوم أو اليوم الصباح. أبغى أسألك بس أسئلة دي. طيب فهنا I am collecting information that I cannot measure objectively other than هنا أقول تعال مثلا the main problem was frustration. ترى هذا مفيد. This is good quality. يعني this is still good quality work. This is still helpful. ما هي numbers. إحنا عبنا نحب numbers. نحب. بس these are not numbers. This is more of a real problem. Spread the way it has and it has a pattern. It can help me to improve service. It can help me to look for a problem. المشكلة الكبيرة في qualitative research إنه إحنا ما نفكر فيه ما نعرف له. شيء ثاني إنه أبغى أسوي qualitative research. وأعمله بشكل مرة خطأ بشكل مرة إنه away from what I'm really measuring فأطلع بأرقام وأعمل أناليسيس ويطلع خويش. I have to really be careful. A lot of what I see now is qualitative research, but it's never labeled as qualitative research. بس it should be qualitative research, بس it should be even done in a better way عشان يكون good quality, good type of qualitative research. ترى ما عندنا كثير في السعودية أنا أشوف qualitative research وما حد يمكن يعرفه. فمهم إنه يعني I suggest go to YouTube اكتب examples of qualitative research, ولا روح PubMed اكتب qualitative research in حط التوبيك اللي تبغاه فيجيب لك حاجة ترى حلوة تفتح راسك تفتح دينك إنه this is something that you can do. وطبعا الكواليتي حقتها ما هي زي الهيراركي اوف بيراميد لانها مختلفه حقت الكوانتيتيف بس فيها برضو اشياء يعني you can really measure. I think finito. شكرا لكم. Thank you very much. Now